I'm really nervous.
Straight on TV.
So we all know that I studied business and Polish as in college. And I'm a beginner, so I don't know. Well, like, I'm not a beginner now, but like, I came in as a beginner, so I don't know that much Polish. Like, I'm not fluent in any way, shape, or form. However, I am going on Erasmus in like a month to Poland for the year, and obviously my thesis at the end of college is all through Polish. So I actually, you know, funnily enough, need to be at a decent level, more than you would think. So we came to this course in Poznan for 3 weeks. We've already done 2 weeks. We only have a week left, which is really sad because it's actually been really fun. I'm gonna do like a week in my life. So today's Friday, so I'm gonna do it till like I leave, which is next Saturday. But I'm gonna start it now because basically it's kind of like a Polish bank holiday this weekend. So like everything's closed. We don't have college and we don't have school on Monday. So we've got like a 3 day weekend, and because everything's closed, we've decided to flee Poznan and we're gonna go to Gdansk. And it's like the most peak time to go to Gdansk. Everything was so expensive and getting there was like ridiculous, but we kind of did it as cheap as we could. We're going there tomorrow and our bus leaves at 2:30 tonight, like tomorrow morning. So we'll be in Gdansk for like 8 a.m. because it's like a 5.5 hour bus. But it'll be worth it. It was only like 15 euro and it was 15 euro back, but we're getting the train home. So we're gonna spend a night in Gdansk, so 2 days. And then we're coming back here on Monday to just chill. Like, we're not gonna probably just play cards. And then I've got the rest of the week of lectures. I need to pack for Gdansk now. We're only going for a night, so like I'm literally gonna wear like a dress, pajamas, and then wear whatever I'm wearing on the bus. But also me and Claire were kind of thinking, because the bus is 2:30, we went out last Friday and it was fun, so we might go tonight and then just like stay out until like this evening and then just go to the bus and like just conk on the bus because it's like 5 hours. And like if I was out on a night out, I don't even think I'd get 5 hours sleep anyways. So like 5 hours is a long time. I don't know. We're really hemming and hawing on the situation. Also, I got my Polish teacher to ring the hairdressers for me to book my hair because it's so much cheaper here. So I'm getting my hair done on Wednesday, which will be fun. Can't speak that like that vocabulary of Polish to tell them that I want like a root blend and face framing highlights. I don't know those words, but my hairdresser doesn't speak English, so my Polish teacher was on the phone to her to try to describe what I wanted. So hopefully I don't come out looking like I was dipped in custard or something. So we've decided to go out so that we KO on the bus. It is currently 10:30. Our bus is at 2:30. So 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30. It's in 4 hours. Here they have different flavors of desperados. They've got like whiskey sour flavor, mojito flavor.
We haven't tried any.
No, we've only stuck with the original, but I ventured out and got red. Tastes the exact same, just with red food dye.
12:30. Our bus is in 2 hours.
Still don't know what I'm saying. No, we'll go that way. Shaprasha. JS Autobusan. Okay, it's 2:45. We finished the bus at 8 a.m. and we came to the beach and we haven't left the beach. So we were on the beach for 6 hours. But it's so busy. It's crazy. But I can't believe we've been there for 6 hours. It's a whole school day. Literally 8 a.m. to 3.
We just lay there.
Slept. Yeah, slept on the beach. Now we're gonna go to our little bed and breakfast situation and check in. I look naked. Checked into our accom. I'll give you room for when we get back. But now we're walking to the old town. The review, I mean, beggars couldn't be choosers and we literally had no other option for accommodation. But the reviews were like excellent location and all this stuff. But it's an hour walk from the old town and that's like where you want to go for Gdansk. Also, Google Maps led us through a forest. So now we're just like walking through a forest.
Oh, I see eyes. Let's go.
I don't know where we are. I'm the only people here. There's literally not a soul. Feels like I'm in the They're like woods and twilight or something.
I was just thinking
Bridge
to Terabithia.
Bridge to Terabithia?
Yeah.
Oh, that's such a sad movie. We're both very sun tired because we were lying in the sun for literally 6 hours. What the fuck? Why is it a dead end?
So.
Okay, I'm going to give you a room tour of our comp that we only paid 40 euro each for. Very, very tough to that price, to be honest. Okay, so walk in, bathroom, and they give you towels, which is a pro. And this is our room. It's two beds. Just live, laugh, love, and life. And there's a fridge, TV, which I actually got to work in English, but we didn't use it because, like, why do you watch TV in Hollis? Then, balcony. Very nice. Gorgeous. I tried some weird thing that I think I filmed and I have no idea what it was. And then I asked my mom what it was and she said she doesn't know. She thinks it might be a new food.
It was, like, we didn't see any of us. So.
But everyone was eating it here. It was like meat with onions and gherkins. And it had on bread and it had like no flavour. Kind of disappointing. It was 2.50 though. Can't complain. She was like, oh, was it a BS with cheese? Does it look like a baguette?
She wasn't.
No. Yeah, our train's at like 8 o'clock and it is like 20 past 4 now, so. Hop off, maybe get a bit of food. I'm not that hungry, but.
We're gonna want dinner.
Yeah. But we'll catch you back in Plaza and probably. Yeah. I look so tanned.
Hop off.
We're back in Poznan, got in last night. It's currently 8 a.m. and we're going for breakfast. So this course basically gives you free meals throughout the day. So you get breakfast, lunch and dinner. I'm just waiting for Claire to come. So we can walk to breakfast together. That's my room. And Claire's room. It is now 4:15. I literally did nothing today. Like, we were so tired. Just like, Gdansk just literally took it out of me and I don't know why. It's ridiculous. Also, I'm getting my hair done on Wednesday. I have to. I'm so excited, but I'm also really nervous because like I can't tell her anything because I don't speak. Like, I can tell her my name and where I'm from and like what I do in college. But I can't tell her that I want face framing highlights, do you know what I mean? And they're the terms that I kind of need. They've got really big roundabouts here, but you can't cross them as a pedestrian. You have to go underground. So like this is the view from my room and that's the roundabout there. So we have to, can you see that place there? It's like a little house thingy. So that brings you underground and then you like walk all the way around. Like this is all underground and then we have to come out here and then we go all the way there and then that's college. But our classes are in that building behind it. I don't know if that was confusing or not, but it's kind of cool. But it's also just kind of confusing because at the start, the Google Maps was like leading us right and we were like, there is no right, we have to go underground. Good morning, it's Tuesday. It's currently like 5 to 8 and about to give her breakfast and then we've got classes until like 12:15. So we're gonna walk to breakfast now. Okay, see you at breakfast. Finished classes and then I'm in a lecture. But I'm scared to talk because I'm by myself. It's currently 4:30. The lecture was from 2 to 3:30 and it was on how Poland escaped communism. It was in English, so we were actually able to understand them. I don't know how I'm gonna be able to pack my lectures in Polish, but hopefully we'll get there one day. And now, see, basically just had lunch. I also forgot to film it because I'm so used to just taking photos, but I'll insert a photo here of it. The soup was really weird. Like, I don't mind beetroot, and we've had a cold beetroot soup before, which I actually liked. This one just had literally zero flavor, so wasn't really up my road. Also, today was like so warm. It was like 32 degrees or something crazy. So, and tomorrow's gonna get, like, tomorrow and Thursday is getting hotter and hotter, so rip. Enigma Museum. The people that run the course like just arrange little excursions for you today, so it's really handy. So now I'm going to get my hair done, and she doesn't speak English, I don't speak Polish when it comes to hair, and I'm really nervous, so wish me luck. Okay. I mean, it did the job. I haven't fully inspected it yet, but like, how bad can it look from afar? I got my hair done, so that's fine. And every place that I went to here were quoting me 470 Zloty, which is like 100 euro. And I asked at the end, because I was too scared to ask at the time, because I didn't ask my teacher to ask and everything. So I was like, "Ile kosztuje?" 150 Zloty, 30 euro. I just paid 30 euro to get my hair done. To be fair, I asked for curls, and like, the place only had two chairs, didn't have a straightener, didn't have a curler, like, she did everything with, like, I felt like my mom was doing my hair. But for 30 quid, I will happily take it. I didn't have cash, so I went to the shop to try and get, like, cash back, and my card wasn't working. They were like, "It's not our problem, it's your bank's problem." I was like, "Fuck off." Anyways, so the woman let me come back tomorrow to pay. She was like, "Come back between 8 and 1 p.m. and just pay me then." And I was like, grand. So I haven't even spent a penny yet. Okay, good morning. It's Thursday. Yesterday I came back from Colossia at like 5:45 or like 6. Just lay down, because the Wi-Fi actually works better when I'm lying down on my bed. Like, it doesn't work when I'm like sitting up. And then I fell asleep and woke up at 1 a.m. So I had like a 7-hour sleep, unintentionally. And me and Claire were meant to go for ice cream at 8, and I woke up at 1. So that was great. Now it is 8 a.m. and I'm currently walking to the hairdressers to pay for what I had done yesterday. Which, I mean, after finally analysing it, I don't think I'd go back. But I would have been curious if someone asked me, "I'll do your hair for 30 quid. Do you know? And I don't think it looks that bad. Also, the layers, like, I don't know how I feel about them, but like, there's no going back now. Now I have layers in my hair. Okay, great. I need to walk there now, but they're all of Poznan being under construction. Like, literally everywhere you walk is just like a temporary path. We also have a test this morning on everything we've learned over the last 3 weeks. And to say that I did not get an ounce of study in would be an understatement, because I fell asleep and woke up at 1 a.m. I'm just gonna wing it. And winging it for Polish is a problem, because you can't cheat the language. I mean, that was the place I got my hair done. Literally just hair salon in the front of it. I mean, now we know. Oh, Jesus. I can't look too close. I'll start to cry. This is where we have classes. It's so hot. I actually want to die and cry. Me and Claire are heading to the shopping center. This is meant to be a halter night shop, but I don't want to get more tan lines, so I turned it upside down, and now it's a halter night shop. We were learning clothes in Polish today, and I said that I was wearing a t-shirt, and she said, "No, that word is for a t-shirt, not a t-shirt that makes you look naked." So, I just don't really like my hair. I'm gonna do a taste test, because I bought this the other day. I've never had it before. Nest tea
mango pineapple. I feel like Lipton is like taking over the iced tea world. Oh. Tastes like pineapple juice. It's like 35 degrees or something crazy. It was, everyone was literally sweating in class. It was disgusting. Why is this a stripe?
Currently at class. It is a mystery wrap. Okay, it's night time now. Finished class, yeah. And there's always really good sunsets here. So we've decided that we want to go to a rooftop bar and watch the sunset. So that is what we are going to do. Me and Claire said we'd meet at 7:30 and this is the first time I'm ready before her. And I just feel a bit superior. I also got these earrings today, I don't know how I feel about them, but yeah. I'll show you what I'm wearing, if I can. I know. I'm ready before you. How does that make you feel?
Pretty
sure. Yeah, I thought so. Morning. It's the last day of college. And once again, I'm out and ready for Claire's.
Finished.
Okay, this is the building. It's actually quite nice to be fair. Okay, sweaty mess secured. Literally me. I can't get over how stripy my hair is. It's also like, what is this? Like, bob vibes. Like what is this? Had the ceremony, so I got my certificate hat. And now, I am so sweaty that this like linen placement number is like sticking to me. And then we're gonna get ready and go out. And we've gotten the whole squad together to go out. So we have cards in the kitchen planned. Cards and cans in the kitchen plan at 8:30, and then we're going to a bar downtown, and then we're going to end up in a club. And these people, these like reps, are like on the main street of Ratswalska. They hand out wristbands to all the girls to get free entry and free drinks for like the whole night until midnight, and then you have to pay for them, or then you don't get free entry if you enter. But like if you enter at 11, you get free drinks for a whole hour. If you're a girl, and free entry. Perks. Okay, this is just not a vibe. It's 7:15 now. Gonna get ready. Actually, I'll show you my certificate. Yeah, she did. Straight on TV. Tomorrow, the Ukrainian band that won Eurovision is playing in Poznan. And me and Claire bought tickets, so we're going. No one else wanted them to go, so we were like, we're gonna go by ourselves. And yeah, I don't know any of the songs. I only know the Eurovision one, not even. It's gonna be fun.
Good morning. Don't think I ever showed you the lift, but like, these are the doors. Isn't that so strange? Like, anyways, and the music is just constantly something weird out of a game show. But the Wi-Fi is not working for me here anymore, so I'm going to go to Starbucks and try and find Wi-Fi.
That is our accommodation, and I'm pretty sure that one is my room.
I am packed. I bought presents. I'll actually show you what I bought today. They cut off our Wi-Fi supply yesterday, so now I ran out of 3G. And I have no Wi-Fi, so I literally can't do anything, which is so fun. But anyways, I packed. Here it is. I was editing a new YouTube video that's going to be going out soon. But I only brought a 10 kg for 3 weeks, so not that bad. pretty good. Claire bought 20 kg, so. But if I, because I would just did Thailand before I came here, and I only had 11 kg for 5 weeks, so I was like, if I can do 11 kg in 5 weeks, I should be able to do 10 kg for 3 weeks.
I got my sister a little real lip balm. I got my mom some weird soup flavors because you can only get them in Poland, and some weird cheesecake thing that she requested, and then 2 bags of Polish fudge. Coming through is gone. It's been a blast. Highly recommend doing, like, no matter what language you're studying, or if you want to study your language, or if, like, you're not even doing it for, like, any, like, educational purposes, if you're just doing it for, like, yourself, like, look up, like, if you're doing German, look up, like, German language courses, and, like, loads of them are funded by the government and, like, give you free accommodation and free food and stuff, so that you can learn language. Like, it's so handy. Like, we got 3 meals a day, accommodation, like, really nice accommodation. Yeah, 3 meals a day, like, bang smack in the city centre. What more could you ask for? And then we're going to, I think I told you before, but we're going to the Ukrainian band concert that won the Eurovision tonight. Because it's their last night and we had nothing to do, and then my roommate's Ukrainian, and she said that the Eurovision band is playing here. Like, literally down the road. And I was like, that's so funny, like, let's just go, like, fuck it. So tickets were like 27 euro, and we decided, like, what else are we doing on the last day? Like, we're not gonna go clubbing or anything. So we just decided to go to it. It's like 10 o'clock and I'm ready to get in bed. I completely panicked. There she is. No, she was 10.9 coming over here. My roommate thinks it's 14. I beg to differ, but we will find out how your, like, handbag's meant to be, like, this size. That's my handbag, and I think it weighs like 6 kilos. The concert was so good, like, it was actually so good, and I couldn't even understand what was going on, and I had fun. Like, I can only imagine the people there that actually could understand for having fun. It was so weird, but it was so good. Like, they didn't use, like, any, like, normal sounds. They had, like, a little ridiculous amount of instruments, like 17 different types of flutes and, like, weird, like, piano amount of things. But they were all, like, all the beats and stuff were all just made from these instruments. It was so cool. Best 30 I spent on trip, I'd say. It was really good. Anyways, I am going to go to bed and wake up at 6:30 and go to the airport. So I'll see you in the morning. It's like 6:45. I'm all packed up and ready to go. It's actually more sad than I thought it would be. I don't really want to leave. I'm really not in the mood to sit in a plane. I was telling Claire, normally planes don't, like, I'm not scared of them, like, they don't, like, bother me, like, I don't really think about them, but I'm just not in the mood to sit in a plane for 3 hours. We landed in Dublin. I hope you enjoyed a week in the life of Polish capitalism.